Good evening, everybody. We will be calling our regularly scheduled council meeting, the Chicago Common Council meeting to order Tuesday, October 9th, 2012. Would you please stand for the pledge?
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Madam Clerk.
Oh, okay. Correction, Monday, October the 8th. Sorry about that.
Who did that?
Okay. Madam Clerk, roll call.
Santos.
Here.
Franciski.
Present.
Battle.
Present.
Vasquez.
Present.
Cuevas.
Present.
Maldonado. Arnold.
Present.
Parks.
Present.
Orange.
Present. Madam Clerk, be advised that Councilwoman Maldonado did call and said that she would not be here tonight.
Okay.
Any communications from the mayor's office?
No.
Communication from department heads?
Yes. Accounts payable warrant 100812CC.
So moved, Madam President.
Second.
Motion was made by Councilman Franciski, second by Councilman Battle. Any questions? Madam Clerk, roll call.
Santos.
Yes.
Franciski.
Yes.
Battle.
Yes.
Vasquez.
Yes.
Cuevas.
Yes.
Arnold.
Yes.
Parks.
Yes.
Orange.
Yes.
Payroll warrant 100112.
So moved, Madam President.
Second.
Motion was made by Councilman Franciski, second by Councilman Cuevas. Any questions? Madam Clerk, roll call.
Santos.
Yes.
Franciski.
Yes.
Battle.
Yes.
Vasquez.
Yes.
Cuevas.
Yes.
Arnold.
Yes.
Parks.
Yes.
Orange.
Yes.
Payroll warrant 092812.
So moved.
Second.
Motion was made by Councilman Parks, second by Councilwoman Vasquez. Any questions? Madam Clerk, roll call.
Santos.
Yes.
Franciski.
Yes.
Battle.
Yes.
Vasquez.
Yes.
Cuevas.
Yes.
Arnold.
Yes.
Parks.
Yes.
Orange.
Yes. Mr. Cinder. And just a reminder, Council, for the next couple of meetings, finance meetings, and also for the final adoption of the budget, please bring your copies that the clerk's office has made. They have made quite a few copies, and there's no reason for her to have to do this again. So if you would just bring them with you to the meetings. If not, then you'd have to kind of share with somebody. Oh, the minutes, okay. I'm trying to move it right along. Before, I don't understand that, Councilman Parks.
Do the motion to accept last meeting's minutes.
Oh, I'm sorry. Did I move that? Okay. Before we do that, I'll get right back to that. Mrs. Cinder, can you just explain what we're gonna be doing with these three ordinances tonight?
Sure. Carl Cinder, financial advisor to the Common Council. Just a brief overview where we've been with the budget process. These next three ordinances are first and second readings on the budget for 2013. The budgets were advertised on September 16th and 13th, I believe. We had a public hearing here in this chamber on September 24th that included the City of East Chicago, the East Chicago Sanitary District, and the School City Chicago's 2013 proposed budgets. We've been having ongoing finance committee meetings on Thursdays, typically at noon, since early September. We've met with the city clerk, city judge, School City of East Chicago superintendent and acting treasurer. as well as City Controller Kim Anderson to go over the various budgets at our Finance Committee meetings. We also had heard back correspondence from the East Chicago Public Library that they are not planning to increase their budget by more than the state growth quotient, thereby exempting them from having to come before you for formal action on their budget. So this evening, I'll just give you a brief overview of where some of the major budgets are. The city's general fund was advertised at $30,800,000, and currently the city administration is recommending to you in your budget packets a general fund budget of $25,842,000. I'll just round to the nearest $1,000 here. And that is in comparison to our actual 2012 budget of $30,755,000. So right there alone, we have a proposed budget from the city administration of $4,813,000.
Deduction?
Deduction in comparison to 2012. One of the reasons for the reduction is the city administration is proposing using less gaming revenues to support the 2013 budget. Their plan is to only use up to $2 to $3 million. Presently, we're anticipating at least $6 million supporting the budget this year. Motor vehicle highways is being proposed at $1,204,000. The Parks Department is proposed at $1,327,000. The Parks actually had a little bit of an increase over last year, and primarily that's because of transfers of individuals that were paid out of the solids budget from the sanitary district, putting them back more into where they're relating the work to. Public transportation is being proposed at $1,423,000. Those are the major city funds with property tax levies. There's other miscellaneous funds, as Ms. Anderson has gone over with you before, and that appeared into the budget advertisement. I'll go on just briefly highlighting the sanitary district solids fund was advertised at $8 million. The budget that the city administration is proposing for 2013 is $7,414,000. And then for the school city of East Chicago, they have a number of funds, and I'll just quickly go through those for you. The general fund is being proposed at $48,874,000. That's in comparison with their current year budget of $50,948,000 for 2012. The general fund for the school is funded solely from state sales tax and other revenues. It is not a property tax-based fund. The debt service fund for the school is being proposed at $2,733,000, comparison for 2012 of $2,432,000. These are actual debt service payments. Exempt debt service fund and bonds on that the school has. The budget for 2013, $11,158,000. Comparison, present year, $11,859,000. Exempt pension debt fund proposed at $391,000. In comparison to this year, $390,000. Capital Projects Fund is being proposed at $6,124,000 versus present year budget of $5,272,000. And finally, their Transportation Fund at $4,667,000, and that's the same as 2012. Latter funds, all of the school funds except for the general fund, are supported by property taxes. So tonight is just your first and second reading on these three ordinances for these entities. And if you have further questions, I'm sure Ms. Anderson's here. I'm here as well. And then we anticipate at your October 22nd meeting, you would take final action on the 2013 budgets.
And could you hold your questions for 1 second? Councilman Parks pointed out that we forgot the minutes. I did forget the minutes. So if we can go back, Madam Clerk, we can have a motion to accept the minutes.
Make a motion to accept the minutes, regular meeting minutes on September 24th.
Second.
Motion was made by Councilman Franciski, second by Councilwoman Vasquez. Any questions? Madam Clerk, roll call.
Santos?
Yes.
Franciski?
Yes.
Battle?
Yes.
Vasquez?
Yes.
Cuevas?
Yes.
Arnold?
Yes.
Parks?
Yes. Mr. Cinder, if, yeah, we did. Mm-hmm. We did that. Mr. Cinder, I know that a few of the councilmen have didn't get a chance to make the finance meeting. So if they can make arrangements with you, if there's something that they need to go through extra that is convenient, I know they do work, and so if they can make arrangements with you to sit down with whatever concerns they have, if they're not going to be able to make it to this Thursday's meeting.
Sure.
If that's okay with the council. Any questions for Mrs. Cinder? Any question on any of the budgets? Mr. Cinder, we use no money for property taxes for the school city?
For the general fund.
Okay,
only the general fund. The other funds that I mentioned, the various debt service funds, the capital projects fund, transportation fund, those are all supported from property taxes. The majority of the support comes from property taxes.
And did Ms. Laura send you the payroll?
I apologize. I did not get a chance to follow up with her this week or since our last finance. I'll make sure we do that and see if we can have that for this Thursday's Finance Committee meeting.
Any questions? Madam Clerk, ordinances on first reading.
Ordinance 12-0026, sponsor Mayor Anthony Copeland, East Chicago Civil City Budget.
So move on first and second reading.
Second.
Motion was made by Councilman Park, second by Councilman Cuevas on first and second reading. Any questions? Madam Clerk, roll call.
Santos?
Yes.
Franciski?
Yes.
Battle?
Yes.
Vasquez?
Yes.
Cuevas?
Yes.
Arnold?
Yes.
Parks?
Yes.
Orange?
Yes. Madam Clerk, any other on first reading?
Yes, Ordinance 12-0027, sponsor Mayor Anthony Copeland, East Chicago Sanitary Budget.
So moved. Second.
Motion was made by Councilman Cuevas, second by Councilman Franciski. Any questions? Councilman Cuevas, is this first and second reading?
Yes, I'm sorry. First and second.
Are you still second? That for first and second?
Yes.
Any questions? Madam Clerk, roll call.
Santos?
Yes.
Franciski?
Yes.
Battle?
Yes.
Vasquez?
Yes.
Cuevas?
Yes.
Arnold?
Yes.
Parks?
Yes.
Orange?
Yes.
Ordinance 12-0028, East Chicago City School Corporation Budget.
So move on first and second.
I'm a cast.
Second, I'm second.
Second.
The motion was made by Councilman Franciski, second by Councilman Parks. Any questions? Madam Clerk, roll call.
Santos?
Abstain.
Franciski?
Yes.
Battle?
Yes.
Vasquez?
Yes.
Cuevas?
Yes.
Arnold?
Yes.
Parks?
Yes.
Orange?
Yes. Any ordinances on second reading?
No.
Any ordinance on third reading?
No.
Any resolutions?
No.
Is there any old business?
You wanted to speak?
I would like to address something that one of the citizens came up and said last week, the last council meeting, when she mentioned the fact that we should have our committee meetings in the evening so that they can attend. I would just like to tell the citizens that normally a committee meeting is not even attended by the public. We have opened them up so that everybody can attend, anybody, the newspaper, or any citizens can attend it. We try to do it at 12 o'clock so that we can get everybody in and then everybody can finish the rest of their day. It's usually, the Finance Committee is made up of three members plus the president. And so, but this year we have tried a little something different so that we make sure that we try to be as transparent as we possibly can. All of our committee meetings from environmental on down has been open to whatever citizens that want to come. And so we will not be changing the time. It will be at 12 o'clock and until we finish our budget hearing. Any other old business? New business? Go ahead, Councilwoman.
Okay. I know we have someone here from Operation SOS who's going to speak on this, and so I'll just give the reminder about the luncheon that's going to take place Sunday, October 21st, at Wicker Park at the Pavilion. And I'll let the chairman speak on it. But I'm just going to pass these down just to share the pictures that we received from the soldiers and the thank you regarding the packages that this organization has sent to them with the generosity of this council. Thank you.
Any other new business? If not, we move to public expression. Juan Andrade.
Juan Andrade, 4005 Elm Street here in East Chicago, Indiana. Just wanted to bring up a point that, you know, this past summer, the last few months, St. Pat's, a lot of churches, I think, a lot of social organizations and so forth, organizations that have some kind of a major event that utilize city equipment and so forth to put their events on. A lot of what happened this year was that in some cases, some people, including, for example, St. Pat's, wasn't informed about these proposed increased fees in reference to, let's say, police and park equipment and so forth. Personally, I know that, you know, a lot of communities have budget issues and so forth, but I think there were a lot of organizations that put on some kind of major event in a city that either canceled their event, scaled down their event, or something to that effect. I would just like to recommend that executive officer, the mayor of the city, the council, and the people from the parks department and department heads come together and call on all these different organizations that have some kind of major event in our community. Bring them all together, hear the people's complaints about the increased fees and so forth, and see what we can all work out together to make sure that when we have our events next year, we can be on a better footing and we understand the issues regarding the budget for the city of East Chicago. Because if nothing is done in reference to this, I would personally think that some of these organizations could wind up having their event in another community outside of East Chicago. Also, on behalf of the Northwest Indiana Media Coalition, which is Nuestra Comunidad Northwest Indiana, WLTH 1370 AM Radio, the 411, the Gary Crusader and Panorama Now Entertainment Magazine, we are going to be having our next event, which is going to be taking place on Saturday, October the 27th from 10 a.m. to 12 noon at the Salvation Army here in East Chicago, which is on the corner of Chicago Avenue and Railroad Avenue. We are going to have Mr. Ryan Holmes, who is the investigative analyst and acting law enforcement coordinator for the Office of the U.S. Attorney's Office, Northwest Indiana. And he's going to do in a breakout session that is going to focus on keeping your kids safe online, for example, chat rooms, social media, and more. So this is going to be, I think, a very important and informative breakout session that's geared to teens, that's geared toward parents, that's geared towards students, and so forth. And it's actually an event that's going to be free and open to the public. And we would like to encourage everyone to attend this event. It's at the Salvation Army here in East Chicago from 10 a.m. to 12 noon on Saturday, October the 27th. And refreshments will be served. So we're inviting everyone to come over to our event. And just one other quick note. I know, Gilda, you were talking about at the last council meeting before I had to leave about the library. East Chicago having two libraries, where in some communities they've had to scale down to one library. And you know, I've been reading, and I'm sure you've probably been reading about Hammond, where the mayor now wants to put the Hammond, consolidate Hammond's library with the county. And in some cases, I think it's a good idea to consolidate countywide. I think in other cases, it's not. But I think too, people have to realize that, myself being a county employee, the county is having its own financial problems. So it's not always the best answer. It may not be always the wisest answer. And I think we just have to take care of our own. And personally, I think that if a community cannot have at least one library, then we got some major, major serious problems. East Chicago has two. You brought up a good point. Maybe they need to look at what they can do to maybe reduce to one library and at least have one library here in the city of East Chicago. Thank you.
Colleen Aguirre.
Hi, I'm Colleen Aguirre of Operation SOS, and on the 21st of October, this Sunday this month, we're going to have an awards dinner. And East Chicago has been they were the beginning of Operation SOS and still are very important in it. And Lenny and Chris and Mary and Vivian and you too, Gilda, you've always been very good about being there for our troops. I brought some pictures. Got an email from this kid, and I think it kind of really like says it all, and I'm handing them out to everyone on the council, so you can see what our boys and girls are doing for us over there.
Ms. Aguirre, can you give them to the clerk, and she'll give them out.
Mm-hmm. And anyway, at this dinner, we're going to give a very, very special flag that we received from the troops, and we sent 250 boxes to the Indiana National Guard. And it was a special flag because they signed it on the white part of the flag. And it came with a two beautiful certificates, one for the flag where it was flown, and one in appreciation for everything that the people back home do for the men and women serving in Afghanistan. Anyway, we're going to present that to Frank Mervan, the township trustee, because he has been absolutely positively wonderful with our troops. He gives them deployment parties and welcome home parties and never charges us for the hall that we use or anything else. And but the best part about this dinner is there's going to be probably 20 of our troops that we have sent packages to there. Some of them are from East Chicago, Becerra, and some of them are from Highland, Indiana. So yeah, I hope you can all make it. I hope you can all be there because it's going to be a very special night. Thank you very much.
Can you give us your address for the record, please?
My address, it's on there, 2922, my home address, 2922 Churchill Lane, Highland.
Thank you.
I put it on there. Okay, thank you.
Mm-hmm. Madam Clerk, any more?
No.
Mm-hmm. Motion to adjourn?
So moved. Second.
Motion was made by Councilman Parr, second by Councilman Cuevas. Madam Clerk, roll call.
Santos.
Yes.
Franciski.
Yes.
Battle.
Yes.
Vasquez.
Yes.
Cuevas.
Yes.
Arnold.
Yes.
Parks.
Yes.
Orange.
Yes. Make sure you bring your budget stuff to the finance meeting.